Irwin Center over the last 11 years. Texas is 157-15. So this has been a tough place for teams in or out of conference to get a win. And West Virginia was that close to winning in regulation. Kalichla, jump hook. No good.
Eric Murray's got to be careful right there. He's got four fouls. Can't be over exuberant. And put his team in a lot. He and Kalichla have gotten good looks in the post area here in the latter part of the second half.
Good hands by Murray to get the takeaway. Then Holmes after the loose ball. Given away at midcourt. Here's Hines crossing over. Unable to finish. The foul called on Felix. That'll put Jabari Hines at the free throw line.
We've seen it tonight, Bob. The 50 balls West Virginia has gotten to. They've been the aggressor here on the road. Getting on the deck. Eric Murray's anticipation there to start that sequence. Excellent defensive possession by the Mountaineers.
Jabari Hines shooting 73% from the line so far this season. But can't hit the first.
Right there you see Jonathan Holmes. A little pigskin action. Can't quite come up with it. Jabari Hines on the line.
19 steals tonight for West Virginia. Murray, offensive rebound, and he'll go to the free throw line, and that'll foul Cameron Ridley out. Cam Ridley fouls out. Papa Petru comes on replacing Sheldon McClellan, but now Prince Ibe will have to sub in for Cam Ridley.
Tough break for Holmes. He looked like he missed time to jump. There was another bounce on the rim. Eric Murray, right place, right time.
So West Virginia now with 12 offensive rebounds tonight. Another big factor in their comeback. And Murray can't hit. It's been a bad night at the line for both teams. And it continues. West Virginia now 11 of 18 at the free throw line.
I'm surprised right now, Bob, that West Virginia is in the man-to-man defense with such foul trouble on the front line.
Backdoor cut, floating in is Lewis. And the follow inside by Prince Ibe.
Good job of Prince Ibe going right to the rim, but Eric Murray went to help defensively, allowed him a straight rim run. Big fella doing what he's supposed to.
Kalichla. Fakes to the baseline, can't finish. Murray, offensive rebound, the putback is good. 13 offensive rebounds for West Virginia.
That's what Bob Huggins envisioned when this young man transferred from LaSalle. A guy that, with great length, would be persistent on the offensive glass. He's really showed that this evening.
Felix rejected by Murray. 3-on-1 for West Virginia. Hines gives it up. Brown will go to the line. That's a pretty good foul by Julian Lewis to at least make the layup difficult for Gary Brown, and still have to earn it at the line.
Watch the help right there. Eric Murray's out of position to box out. Prince Ibe taking advantage, and then right there, there's a double team on Kalichla. Eric Murray does the same thing, follows the flight of the ball to the rim with the putback.
Now one of two at the line tonight. He has 7.
It's going to be a road-tested crew before the end of the conference schedule. West Virginia will have flown 23,000 miles round trip in their inaugural season in Big 12, but they are playing like road warriors tonight.
What trip in the Big 12 for West Virginia is short?
None. I mean, if this were regulation, they were going to get home at 5 o'clock in the morning.
Might be 5:15 now. Coming up on 3 minutes to go in overtime. A foul up top called on Aaron Harris.
And the first one, number 10, Aaron Harris is first.
First on Harris. That's team foul number 8. Against West Virginia, so a 1-1 for Sheldon McClellan. McClellan is 5 of 9 at the line. He's 5 of 10, but eBay gets the offensive rebound.
A lot of times, Bob, when you have injured ankles, you can't get up on your toes on the follow-through, resulting in the short attempt by McClellan. He's got it out, but nowhere near 100%.
Lewis to the corner, wide open look, and McClellan in and out for three.
I like his box of taking it, though. That was the right shot.
Brown sets up Hines. In and out at this end, but an offensive rebound run down by Brown. And a fresh 35 for West Virginia.
That was a good attempt. That was right down, and he's coming off hitting a big one. So West Virginia start confidence rising right before our eyes.
Kalichla thrown to the deck by eBay. The officials say play on. Brown, he'll try a triple. That hit the backboard first. Murray, an offensive rebound.
Eric Murray is so long. And if Bob Huggins would have gotten this effort from their front line, they probably would be 1-0 right now. They gave up 5 offensive opportunities down the stretch at home against Oklahoma in their Big 12 opener.
Hines to the corner. And Harris resets to Brown. 10 on the shot clock. Harris thought about a three, off to Brown. Now it's Hines, 5 to shoot, a floater, comes up short. Back tap to Brown, another 35-second shot clock for West Virginia. This is going to be a 2-minute possession by the time 3 to go. But this has been already close to a 2-minute possession with the offensive rebounds at this end for West Virginia. And still 27 to shoot.
Take a little time off the possession.
Why not with a 2-point lead? Contested pass. Murray tracks it down with 12 to shoot. Now it's Gary Brown. Down to 9 on the shot clock. Brown gets a screen. At the free throw line. Turnaround floater won't go. Kalichla lost the rebound to eBay. And then commits a foul. That'll be against Kalichla. He will foul out. So that will put Prince eBay at the free throw line as Kalichla has fouled out.
Prince eBay sticking his head in the fray. Without Cameron Ridley in the game, the foul trouble. He's got to be the anchor. Let's go get that defensive rebound, and he did.
So now Kalichla is out. Eric Murray has 4 fouls. Dominique Rutledge has 4 fouls. And Prince eBay will go to the free throw line. He is 2 of 3 at the line tonight, but came into tonight only 30% as a free throw shooter on the season.
Right now he's already making a mistake because he's on the line too soon. Typically you want to get to the line right before you get the basketball.
Freshman center from Garland, Texas. A chance to tie the game. And he's got the first.
That's why I call games.
That's the reverse announcer jinx.
Yes.
It was a hockey game tonight for Dennis Kalichla. That second one, not as pretty. And it's a 1-point game with 50 seconds to go.
Well, if you're Texas, you don't have to foul. Just play solid defense, force a miss, and clean up the defensive glass. You've got plenty of time.
On to the corner. Brown on the baseline into a double team. Harris for 3. Off the mark. Long rebound to the corner. Rutledge somehow, as he's falling out of bounds, saves it back in, and now Texas does have to foul. And Julian Lewis gives the foul on Gary Brown. That was a terrific play by Dominique Rutledge as he was tripping and falling out of bounds. 2 of 3 at the line tonight. Even if he makes both, Texas still has a chance. And he misses the front end.
Both coaches going to lock their teams in the gym and work on some free throws. 24 missed free throws between the two teams.
Yeah. 2-point advantage for West Virginia. Still a timeout for Rick Barnes. Will he use it?
And does West Virginia foul?
Up by only two, I can't imagine that they will. And Murray gets a steal. And McClellan commits the foul with 6.5 seconds to go.
Excuse me there, Bob. I thought they got it. Got excited, thought they were up three there for a moment. Good job defensively by West Virginia. Shooting the passing lanes, Eric Murray. His length is so impressive.
Automatic double bonus, Eric Murray to shoot a pair. And the first makes it a three-point game. Here's the foul shot that would make it a two-possession game. Will Texas lose both of their first two games in Big 12 play in overtime? Murray's got them both. And now the Longhorns are in deep trouble. Here's Felix. Has to try a three. He will. Comes up way short. And that'll do it. Down by 13 in the second half in their first ever Big 12 road game. West Virginia comes from behind to win it in overtime. And Texas opens up the Big 12 schedule with back-to-back losses. It's time for Washington and Cal. Good night from Austin.